I'm James Hand, and this is
John Neville.
Where did you grow up, and what was it like?
Well, I grew up, I spent my summers on the Gray Islands. That would be like probably around 5 months of the year, from the end of June until probably the end of October. And that was for 18 years, 18 summers, and the rest of the time I was in St. John's.
How many people were in your family?
We had a small family. There was only two of us, except for my brother, and of course my parents. You know. But there were lots of other relatives there, you know, cousins and that kind of people. You never see immediate family, you know.
What types of things did you eat?
What types of things did we eat? Well, mostly we ate fish, you know. And of course we ate lots of game. We ate, you know, like rabbits and partridge and ducks and that type of thing. And we grew our own vegetables. We had our own chickens, that kind of thing, you know. So
did you have
had our own eggs.
Cows?
No, we didn't have any cattle, but there was lots of people on the island that had cattle. We didn't have any because we didn't stay there during the winter. So.
What was your favorite meal?
Oh, I would say my favorite meal then, and probably still my favorite meal, was codfish. Pan-fried cod.
What was your typical day like?
A typical day, well, from the first, I guess up until I was about age 12, my typical day was, well, I'd get up early because my father used to go fishing. And I'd be just working, laying around on the beach in the sand and building castles and playing with wooden boats in the water. Sometimes I'd go fishing, go trouting. There was rivers close by, so I didn't have to go very far. You'd picking berries, and I always had a dog, so I'd play with the dog and things like that.
How did you get around the Gray Islands?
We had to walk everywhere we went because there was only footpaths, so no vehicles at that time or anything. And of course, if you go around in boats at times, you know, if you want to go to another harbor, another cove or something like that, you had to go by boats.
What type of games do you
play? Games? Well, let me think that. We used to play a game, one game we used to play was called Piddly. Or Tiddly, I can't remember, but I think it was Piddly. They played it with sticks. And it's still played, actually. It's played in England, believe it or not. And we used to play soccer. We had a soccer ball and played that. And that kind of things, you know. There wasn't a lot of games. They catch foot, have a glove and baseball and everything.
So you didn't have the normal toys that they had today?
Oh, no. We didn't have my brother had a bike. I didn't have a bike. But anyway, there wasn't much place to ride a bike, to be honest, particularly. We'd ride around on a footpath. That was mainly. Oh yeah, we played hide and go seek and all that kind of stuff. Up and hide in the woods, you know, that type of thing.
Tell me about any traditions that you remember from your time, which are not around anymore.
Oh, let me think about traditions. Well, there was a lot of things, I suppose, in
like
a way.
There
was, like, just to give you an example, like, we used to make and mend our own shoes. My father did. Had a lasp and nails, and it had leather. He used to cut leather and all that kind of stuff. And the shoemaker would do it today, but, I mean, at that time, each individual. And also, as far as, we didn't have any electricity, of course, but we did have a wind charger, and that used to charge up the batteries. And we had a battery-operated radio, see? And you had to keep your batteries charged. And also, in the boat, that you had the engine in the boat, you had to have a battery pack to start the engine, and then you had to charge up those batteries, too. So that was one thing that I don't think you see much of today. There are still garden parties around, but one of the traditions there was on the 15th of August. We used to have what was called Lady Day, and on the 15th of August, it was called the Feast of the Assumption. But we used to have a garden party, and they'd have, the women, of course, did most of the work. You'd have games to be playing, you'd have grab bags and things like that. Then they'd have a dinner, and have all kinds of cakes and cookies, and have the big meal, and then after that they'd have a dance. And my father used to play for the dance, he used to play the accordion.
How did you get food to the ground?
Well, a lot of the food we secured ourselves. We had our own, the fish, you caught a lot of fish, of course. And we grew our own vegetables, had our own vegetable gardens, and got a lot of game. We used to hunt the game, like rabbits and partridge and things like that, ducks. But now the basic foods that you had to have, like steak, flour and sugar and these type of things, you know, that came by coastal boat. These were boats that used to go around the coast, and they would probably come every 2 weeks, and you'd have to order that from a supplier in St. John's.
And mail too.
And the mail came by the boat, and actually that's how we had to travel back and forth to get there by boat as well. They were called coastal boats.
What was your favorite thing to do in the
Grand? My favorite thing to do? Well, I used to go swimming, of course, because the beaches in the summer, the water's fairly warm. I like to go fishing, I like to go hunting.
Just to pick things up from the beach.
Oh, I used to be a beachcomber. I was a big beachcomber. I used to go around and pick up stuff that drifted ashore on the beach, on the beaches. And believe it or not, one time I found a $20 bill.
There was a lot of money back then.
There was a lot of money, and it was kind of dry, it was kind of fragile. So anyway, I kept it, and I put it in an envelope, and I sent it off to the Mint in Ottawa, expecting to get more than $20 back, because that's all I got back.
What do you miss most about the Grand?
Well, right now, I have to say, the most is the open air, and the, you know, miss the beach, miss... It's just one beautiful place, that's what it is. It's lots of things to do.
Mention the bake apples.
Lots of berries and bake apples and blueberries and partridge berries and bake and lots of trails and not trails, but you could do lots of hiking and things like that. So it was just a wonderful outport, you know. That you know, unfortunately is not accessible right now. It's pretty hard to get to.
How many people lived in the Grand?
Well, there wasn't a lot of people. There was probably between 125 and 150. It's varied. That was the most that ever lived there. That's permanently. There were people who came there in the summertime to go fishing and others, but I would say there was never more than 200.
Do people live in the Grand Islands now?
No, they don't live. The Grand Islands was resettled. That was where they all moved out in 1961. And people still go back there just to stay. There's a few cabins there. They go back there to hunt and fish and pick berries and that kind of stuff. But it's more recreation now. People don't live there permanently anymore.
Thank you for sharing the story.
Oh, it's a pleasure. Anytime.